Released on November 10th, 1998, Twisted Metal 3 takes the series in a new direction with its way different gameplay and much sillier nature. You see, the first two Twisted Metals were made by Singletrack, but Twisted Metal 3 and 4 were made by 989 Studios, and apparently they didn't understand the source material. Because of this, Twisted Metal 3 was received with poor reviews when it first released, and to this day is considered the worst game in this series. So what went wrong? Well, sit back as I dissect this garbage heap of a game. The gameplay of Twisted Metal 3 is still similar to its predecessors, but there are some major differences. First, the combat system feels different. It's faster and looser than the sometimes sluggish and tight controls of previous entries. It feels alright, but it makes Twisted Metal feel more like a racing game and less like a vehicle or combat game. Let's talk about some of the new mechanics. First is regeneration. Regeneration occurs in some levels once the player has destroyed all the enemies, and two or three more come back to fight again. The new weapons are pretty cool. Speed missiles, small-sized missiles that don't do a lot of damage, but fire at high speeds. Motars, missiles that shoot with an arc rather than shoot straight from the front of the car, and due to their bad accuracy, they do a good deal of damage. And storm missiles, a barrage of missiles that shoot into the air and land back onto unsuspecting enemies. They're fun to use and add to the variety of gameplay. There's only 4 advanced attacks in this game, as opposed to the plenty of advanced attacks in Twisted Metal 2. However, they do feel a lot more responsive than last game. The different point of views are back too. Players can view their vehicle from afar, from just behind, or take their field of vision to the driver's seat. This game also introduced portals into the series, so players can teleport across the map to hidden areas or to simply escape enemies. There's also an option to have a CPU ally to help the player go through the tournament mode, and they can either allow or not allow the CPU to share the same life pool. Now, let's talk about the new characters. Twisted Metal 3 introduced Augur, a construction worker furious at the Twisted Metal contestants always destroying his creations. The blade on the front of his vehicle spins and throws anybody foolish enough to get near it. Club Kid, a radical dude that wants to party all night and live the high life. His car wields the Vortex, which sucks enemies towards the car and spins them out whenever they get close enough. Firestarter, a crazy pyromaniac that wishes to win the contest so he can have an open barbecue with all of his friends. His hot rod spews a giant flame and burns enemies to a crisp. And lastly, Flower Power, an environmentalist angry at the destruction Twisted Metal brought upon Mother Nature, and plans to get revenge by doing the exact same thing that she's against. Flower Power shoots out a giant flower that blasts other vehicles with pollen. No, I'm not making that up. Well, honestly, none of these vehicles are really anything to write home about. They're pretty standard entries for the series, and nothing really sticks out about them. Augur is just a reskin of Mr. Slam, Firestarter steals Stumper's special, Club Kid is the obligatory radical dude, and Flower Power is just lazy design that doesn't fit at all with the Twisted Metal series. The returning characters are fine, for the most part. Gameplay-wise, they feel pretty close to their counterparts from the previous games, but design and personality-wise, they lack a lot. But we'll get into that later. Enough of the single-player stuff, let's talk about the multiplayer. Not much has changed for the multiplayer. Players can grab a friend and go through the co-op tournament, or have a deathmatch battle. Or, they can grab 3 friends and face each other in a 4-player fight. The only downside being it seems to lag a little bit. But other than that, it's pretty fun. Twisted Metal 3 takes a huge turn away from the previous entry's more darker aesthetic for something brighter, has more color, and pops out. This design change fits the game, it wasn't really a good change, but I'll get into that later. The cutscenes are now CGI rendered instead of being hand animated, and they've aged poorly and seriously lack the charm of the first two games. It's not even the fact the CGI is from the late 90s, it seriously lacks any type of personality, it's just a sludge of polygons with that god-awful lighting. The graphics in-game don't look bad for a game released in 1998. Pretty standard, nothing really sticks out. Now, what about the character design? The designs are alright, nothing terrible, but nothing outstanding. The characters just aren't as cool in terms of personality or design compared to the previous Twisted Metals. Okay, how about some positivity? The levels in this game are actually pretty good. They're full of secrets, fun to drive around, and have plenty of things to destroy. Speaking of levels, let's do the obligatory analysis. Hollywood. A destroyed Californian highway serves as the battlefield for the first level. Players can stay on ground or go up to the road to get away from the competition or get some extra weapons. Washington, D.C. Taking place right outside the Capitol building, chaos ensues around this small enclosed area where players can't hide from the stinging missiles and special attacks. After killing the other three contestants, the player will fight Darkseid, who reappears from Twisted Metal 1. Hangar 18. The highly rumored secret hangar is full of alien tech and unearthed secrets. A UFO sits right in the middle of the map, and players can get on top of the level if they figure out how. And, if they do so, they'll get a highly destructive environmental attack. The North Pole. Players find themselves at the top of the world, where they'll have to take on the icy ground and take down their enemies. Christmas decor, such as candy canes and presents, fill up this level, which isn't surprising considering this is where Santa Claus lives. London. This big city, surprisingly, isn't destroyed and serves as a great battleground. The level contains many open spaces and pathways, so players can find a balance of destroying their enemies and running away whenever they need health or more weapons. Minion serves as this level's mini-boss and is just as hard as he was in Twisted Metal 2. Tokyo. If the contestants are smart, they'll stay on top of the rooftops, as falling down will drop them into a pool of lava where they'll start taking damage and burn up if they don't escape. Players can jump between the buildings thanks to the ramp spread throughout the level. There's also a special weapon called the radar, and a huge spinning fan players can take advantage of if they know what they're doing. Egypt. This level takes place in the dunes of Egypt, where players will scale mountains and explore tombs where they can find secrets. It's a bit more barren in terms of visuals, but the gameplay of this map provides the excitement. Calypso's Blimp. Calypso invites the final members of the tournament to his blimp, where they'll battle out until there's only one remaining. Players will have to deactivate the switch on top of the level by finding four other switches on the lower level of the blimp in order to make the enemies stop regenerating. Once they stop the regeneration and kill their enemies, Primeval comes out to try and squash the last standing contender. Once Primeval is trashed, the player meets with Calypso, where he'll grant their wish. There's also three hidden levels, which are activated via the password screen. Two warehouse levels, which can be seen in the background of the main menu, and Club Kid's House, which is basically a huge disco set. These levels do feel a bit repetitive compared to what Twisted Metal 1 and 2 had, but they still hold their own, are filled with secrets, and are fun to play on. The menus of Twisted Metal 3 are all held within the main menu, unlike Twisted Metal 1 and 2, where the menus would branch off into their own topics. There's no unique images or animations that sit behind the menu screens. Instead, the text just changes as CPUs endlessly fight in the background. The character select screen is similar to previous games, where an image of the fighter is shown with their vehicle, with an option to view the character's biography and stats. The sound design in Twisted Metal 3 isn't that much different from the first two games, a banging soundtrack with impactful sound effects. The biggest difference comes with the soundtrack. The soundtrack is still rock and metal songs that are filled with energy, but they're mostly tracks from other artists. Well, to be specific, it's only two artists, Pitchshifter and Rob Zombie, with Lance Lenhart composing three original tracks for the game. And one more thing, Calypso gives a narration whenever the player loads into one of the eight levels from the tournament mode.
To Twisted Metal. Your first battleground will be the once pristine City of Angels. It's been only 18 months since the Great Quake of 2007 left the city in rubble. May the best contest.
The characters will also provide a narration about themselves whenever the player picks the more information option on the character select screen. Other than that, there's nothing else to say about the sound design in this game.
Yeah!
Twisted Metal 3 doesn't really have any extras. It has a good amount of cheat codes players can enter at the password screen, but other than that, there's nothing. In terms of issues, Twisted Metal 3 is full of them. The biggest issue is this game's direction and destruction of the original Twisted Metal feel. Twisted Metal is supposed to be dark, edgy, and gritty. It's a game that takes place in a world where people are so desperate to win a prize, they'll risk their lives in a highly destructive environment. Not to mention, the huge lack of authority and order. Twisted Metal 3 really dumbs it down by making the cutscenes less interesting, and in a way, satirizing it. The ending cutscenes are the worst offenders for a few reasons. Number 1. They have no respect for any of the characters. Calypso is a trickster, and has been known to twist the winner's words. However, he's reasonable, as sometimes the fault lies within the winner's poor judgment and not thinking their wish through in more terms than their diction. In this game, Calypso is a complete asshole, and every character is screwed over. The first two games had it so the characters could show a wide range of emotions from their prize and the consequences that came from their lack of judgment or their personality. They were well written, and the characters and their wishes weren't two-dimensional. They made sense and were reflective of what the contestants personally wanted. 989 Studios completely threw out the idea of what these endings meant, in that Calypso gives everybody a bad ending just because he sometimes is malicious with other people's words. He doesn't even grant Mr. Grimm his wish, he simply steps on him. The second issue. The characters and their wishes are bland as hell, and sometimes don't add up to their descriptions. Take for example, Augur. In his description, he talks about destroying the people partaking in Twisted Metal because they keep destroying his buildings and projects. One would infer he would get more than just revenge with those that wrecked his creations if he won the contest due to the tone of his words and the description. But instead, he wishes to inhibit his inner child. It's not even about the specifics of these characters. Most of their wishes don't make sense. Thumper just wants to hang out with his homies. Well, I can understand why that might be difficult due to the Twisted Metal contest, but why would he put himself through that torment just so he can hang out with his friends? I could go on and on about these terrible endings, but I have to move on to other issues plaguing this game. The second issue comes with the gameplay. The cars just feel too slippery. I find myself on my back constantly and having to wait for the game to flip me over. The controls feel awkward at many times, and even with the vehicles that have the best controls, I don't feel like I have 100% control over my vehicle. This heavily impacts the accuracy of weapons the player fires, which in return makes it harder than it should be to hit enemies with certain missiles because the player slightly bumps a wall and their vehicle decides to just flip over. Another big issue I have is enemies will go out of their way to get health back instead of just occasionally bumping into them. To be honest, this issue really isn't that bad when the regular enemies do it, but it's a huge issue when a mini-boss or primeval is almost defeated and they completely set back one's progress by picking up a full health pack. These issues ruin the feel and gameplay that the Twisted Metal series was known for. Players can still have fun with this game, it's not like it's boring or not packed with action, it just feels so off-color for Twisted Metal in pretty much every aspect. Twisted Metal 3 is a rather piss-poor game that is nowhere near as fun or as cool as the previous entries due to the lack of respect towards the source material and going in a direction that didn't make sense for the series. The game has its moments, but the bastardization of the Twisted Metal formula kills any chance of this game living up to its predecessors or just being a decent entry. Let's count up everything this putrid game has to offer. 14 playable characters that have a decent amount of variety and fun factor, 11 levels that are full of secrets, pathways, and actually have good design, an energetic and appropriate soundtrack despite the fact most tracks weren't made for the game, a 4-player game mode that's a bit laggy but definitely worth getting a multi-tap and 3 other friends for, the option to use a CPU ally that may or may not die immediately, cheat codes that are fun to mess around with, painstakingly bad cutscenes and endings, and a bunch of other material from the last two games. Twisted Metal 3 failed to deliver a decent follow-up to the amazingness that was Twisted Metal 2. It still is an infamy as the worst game in the series. The game doesn't hold a candle to the atmosphere and vibe Twisted Metal 1 and 2 had, not in its gameplay or cutscenes. All in all, it's an alright game, but a terrible contender for a Twisted Metal game. And until next time, well, at least the next game's not so bad.